Hi, good afternoon. Happy Tuesday. I had to think about what day it was. Give me a second here to make this comment. I hope everybody is doing well today. We are doing a 30-minute scoliosis class, and it's going to be a little bit more advanced. I'm doing some plank work. Hold on one second. I'm gonna tag this. I'm still getting used to all these different things here. Okay, just pinning the comment. All right. So hi, I am Megan. I'm a doctor of physical therapy and a Pilates instructor. I specialize in scoliosis conditions and pre and postnatal stuff. So we are going to do some work. If you have a flat wall, I'd like you to get your mat and get kind of close to it because we're gonna be doing some work using the wall. And I'm using this little weird board thing, but it should do the job because I left my mat somewhere last week, so I won't be able to use that. But we're going to get started here in a seated position. So we're going to start off with some elongation just to begin with, and that's how we generally start all of our classes, especially scoliosis classes, with some elongation. So that helps to set the spine right, it helps you to focus on your corrections a little bit before we get started. So what I like you to do is, if you can get into a cross-legged position and still have a nice tall spine, go ahead and do that. If you're really struggling to upright that spine, you can find a chair or a bent knee position. So I'm going to start with my knees over the side of the table here, and my hands are going to be propped back behind me a little bit. So I'm going to push into my knuckles and lift my spine up nice and tall, and I'm going to inhale in this position. And then as I exhale, I'm going to be drawing my hollow ribs back towards my arm. So that's my tide pool side or my concave side, the side that's pushed in. And for me, that's my left side. So again, you're going to inhale in this position. And then as you exhale, try to draw those ribs back towards the arm. And maintaining your nice upright spine here. And inhale again. And exhale. Drawing those ribs back. Still staying nice and tall and lengthened. Good. And inhale again. And exhale. Draw those ribs back towards the arm. Still staying nice and tall. Trying to push the opposite ribs forward. Good, go ahead and relax. Shake it out just a little bit. Okay, so next we're going to do some weight shifting or muscle cylinders. So if you're familiar with scoliosis work, this will make sense to you. What it's doing, it's trying to brace all of the muscles that surround the spine so that you are evening out the spine. So what I'd like you to do, we're going to walk our hands out to the sides here. And if you can get your feet flat, if you're in a chair, onto the ground, it'll work a little bit more easily. You can still do this with your legs stretched out in front of you. And I just want you to begin shifting your weight over to your left. And then coming back to center and shift your weight over to your right and come back to center. So we're not side bending over here. I'm over exaggerating, but even this isn't right. You want to make sure both sides of the waist are staying the same distance. So if your thumb's at the bottom of your ribs and your pointer fingers at the tops of your hips, it's going to stay the same distance. You're not going to collapse to the side that you're leaning towards. It's
staying nice and even. And then you're going to shift the other way. Good. And return to center. And shift again. Still elongating. And back to center. And shift again. So as I'm shifting to my left, I'm pressing into my right foot a little bit more. If your legs are straight, it'll be right your leg that you're pressing into. And just go ahead and shake it out a little bit. Nice work. Okay, so now we're going to add on to that and hold it a little bit longer. So same, I like the hand position here. So same position here. I want you to shift over to your right or your left. And while you're here, you're going to inhale and exhale. Draw the belly button back towards the spine. And inhale again. And exhale. Brace the abdominals a little bit. And we're going to do one more time, inhaling here. And exhale. Good, return to center and kind of shake it out. So again, we're not just side bending over, we're shifting the weight over, maintaining the length on both sides of the waist. Okay, so now we're over to your right. We're going to inhale in this position. And exhale, dropping the navel back towards the spine, not shrinking, growing a little bit taller. Inhale again. And exhale. And one more time, inhaling. And exhale, pulling that belly back towards the spine. Good, return to center and shake it out. Okay, so we're going to make our way into a quadruped position next. So this is more a little bit plank work, but planks for people that have scoliosis are really difficult to maintain your correction. So maintain the rotation of the ribs the proper way, keeping the ribs drawn into the body. So we're going to start out onto our hands and knees. Your hands will start out directly under the shoulders, knees under the hips. And now I just want you to walk out onto your fingertips a little bit ahead of the shoulders. And you're going to begin tucking those toes under. So you're finding a nice long spine, and I want you to begin shifting your weight back towards your heels, drawing up really strong through the abdominals. You want to feel like you have suction cups on your fingers. So you're really pressing down, pulling the tailbone back in opposition, and then shift your weight forward over those hands. Good. So you're shifting back, elongating through both sides of the waist, really drawing up strong through the center. And then pull yourself forward. You're going to inhale in this position. And then exhale, shift the weight back. So this is step one. We're going to add on a couple of different steps as we go through the class here. And shift the weight forward, inhaling. Shoulders are set down the back, and exhale, good. So you're still reaching through the crown of the head, reaching with the fingertips, kind of dragging your fingers on the table without moving, and then shifting forward. And one more time, exhaling. And then shift forward, good. Go ahead and shake it out. And we're going to make our way into a side lying position. So I'm going to begin laying onto my concave side. So that's my tide pool side, the side that's sunken in. And for me, that's my left side. So I'm really stretching out, trying to lay each rib down onto the mat. And then I'm reaching out through my top leg, which is my right leg. My right arm is reaching up towards the ceiling. And I'm sinking that shoulder into my body and trying to maintain contact with the mat the entire time. So you're going to stretch through the top leg and just begin lifting and lowering. Good, really pulling back through your center, keeping the shoulders stacked, the hips stacked. Good, and maintaining contact with that bottom side. Good. times here, lifting and lowering, keeping that leg nice and straight. Trying not to curl in on yourself. Good. Now go ahead and straighten out both legs. So the bottom leg is straight as well. You're still maintaining contact here. And then continue lifting and lowering, sinking that top shoulder into the body here. Really pulling back strong through the center. Good. Sorry, it's so dark. It's been raining all day here. Try to make as much light as I could in here. Good, just a few more times. Still reaching long with that top leg. Good, lower that leg down, shake it out. Good, bend the knees and just kind of lift and lower both feet here. Releasing through the spine a little bit. All right, nice work. And now we're going to make our way over to the other side. So for me, this is my convex side or my sand dune side. This is the side that's raised up and pushed backwards. So my goal here is to keep this side of the waist lifted the entire time. So I'm going to lay down onto this side and keeping my bottom leg bent, my top leg is straight. I'm going to lift my top arm up and over, and it helps to keep the bottom side of my waist lifted the entire time. So no contact here, opposite of what we just did on the other side, and begin lifting and lowering. Good, so you're breathing, really drawing back strong through the center. Really nice work. And just a few more times for three and two and one. Good, go ahead and straighten out both legs here, still remaining lifted. Reaching this arm up and over. Good, creating that nice space. The top side of the ribs that like to collapse in on each other. Sort of lifting and lowering the top leg. Awesome work. You're breathing. It's easy to want to hold your breath in these positions, but it's not going to do you any good to do that. And last time, good. Let that leg relax. Bend the knees and just lift and lower the feet together, releasing through the spine a little bit. Really nice work. Okay. So we're going to flip back onto our hands and knees and add on to that plank work that we did earlier. So I want your hands, same starting position. They're not going to be directly under the shoulders. They're going to be reaching out just slightly ahead of the body. Toes are tucked under. Nice long spine. And you're going to begin shifting the weight back. And you're pulling in super strong with your abdominals. Let the knees lift a little bit to a hover. Set the knees down. And then shift the weight forward over the hands. Good. And exhale. Still getting nice and long. Hover the knees. Good. Lower the knees. And shift the weight forward. Good. Again, exhaling. Maintaining that nice long spine. And pull the weight forward. Good, so we're not hiking the hips up and doing a little booty party here. You're keeping the hips down. Good, and just hovering those knees a couple inches and shift the weight forward. So this is a plank party, not a booty party. Good, and exhale. Hover the knees, pull back strong through the core. And one more time, exhaling, shifting back, and hovering the knees. Good, lower the knees, and shift forward. Good, very nice work. So hopefully you're near a wall here, and I want you to get nice and close to the wall. And we're going to be, I'm laying wall that can, you can have your feet planted onto the wall. And I'm stretching out through that bottom side of the waist, trying to maintain contact the entire time. My feet are standing strong into the wall, or my little board here. Top arm is reaching up to the ceiling, and I'm sinking that shoulder into the body. Good. So the bottom leg is staying planted. You're going to lift the top leg off, reaching it long, and then place that foot back onto the wall and stand onto it. So this in itself is a side plank. And stand onto that foot. Good. And lift the leg off. And return. And step onto that foot. And three more times, lifting and lowering back down. Step onto the foot. And two more times. And back down and stand onto that foot. And last time. And lower it back down. And you're really standing strong, keeping the ribs in contact there. But now that top leg is staying still where it is, the bottom leg bends. And now I just want you to begin lifting that foot up towards the ceiling and then lower back down. So you're really pressing with that top leg into the wall and lower back down. Rotating that bottom hip. Good. Trying not to curl in on yourself. I really like to do that. Good. Pulling back through the center. And two more times, pressing into the top leg, keeping this contact with that bottom side of the waist. And one more time. Lower back down. Good, go ahead and release that leg, bend the knees, and just do a few releases here with the legs. Good, nice work. So I'm going to turn and face away from you. Hopefully you can still hear what I'm saying. So this is my convex side, my sand dune side that's pushed back towards you. I'm focusing on keeping the side of the waist lifted the entire time. Okay, so I'm going to lay down onto the side. Legs are stretched out. I have such a hard time judging here. Okay, so your feet are pressing strong into your wall and you're staying lifted with this bottom side of the waist. My arm is reaching up and over, and I'm going to lift that top leg up and lower it back down and stand onto that foot and lift it off and lower back down and stand onto that foot. Good. This is a lot of core work, really pulling back through the center. And lower down and step onto that foot. Three more times here. These bottom ribs are staying lifted the entire time. Good. Really opening up through these top ribs that like to collapse in on each other. And just one more time. Lift it off. And lower back down and stand. Good, go ahead and bend that bottom leg. And you're really pressing strong through your top foot into the wall. And I want you to begin rotating the foot up towards the ceiling and lower back down. And rotate up and lower. Do, do, do. Okay. Three more times. And two. And one more time. Good. Allow it to relax. Bend both knees. Keep your feet together. And just rotate the both feet up towards the ceiling. Kind of releasing, relaxing through the spine here. Okay. Very nice work. All right. So we're going to when I first heard piano key, I was thinking it was meaning ribs or each level of the spine laying it down. But what it really means is thinking about, so we're focusing here on the concave side. This is the side that's pressed forward and sunken in. And for me, that's the left side of the spine, right in here. So you want to think of your spine as one key, and then right next to the spine as another key. And then you just keep working your way out further and further and further, okay? So that'll make a little bit more sense as we do it. So we're going to lay onto your back. And I want you to have your left leg bent, or this is the same side as your tie pull, the side that's sunken in. You want to have that leg bent. And now reach both arms up to the ceiling. And I want you to try and separate your shoulders away from each other, reaching the fingertips up to the ceiling, and then drop the shoulders back. And then you're going to reach up again, trying to separate between the shoulder blades, and lower back down. And two more times, reaching up, and back down. And one more time, reaching, and lowering back down. Good, so I'm going to place my right hand on top of my right shoulder here. I'm going to keep my left arm reaching up to the ceiling. And now I want to reach up and over across the body and roll onto my side. I'm really trying to open up between these ribs here in this position. And now I want you to inhale while you're in this position, trying to expand a little bit more. And then exhale again, opening up even more, reaching your arm towards the wall. And then inhale again. And then as you exhale, begin rolling back onto your back, trying to lay each one of those piano keys down at a time. So I'm laying my spine down first. Good. And then my ribs. Good. And then right next to that. Good. And keep going until your shoulder plugs back into the mat. Good. Stay in this position. Try and keep the contact with the back of the ribs into the mat. It's very challenging here. They don't want to go. Inhale while you're in this position. And exhale, keep the contact there. And inhale again. And exhale. Try to press them further down into the mat. Good. Now we're going to reach up and over across the body again. So reaching over towards this wall. Good. I want you to hold this position, try to reach your fingertips a little bit further, stretching behind that shoulder blade. Inhale while you're in this position. And exhale. Good, try to open up and stretch a little bit further here. And inhale again. And exhale. Reach those fingers further. And then inhale again. And then as you exhale, begin rolling back onto your back. Good. You're trying to lay your spine down first. And then those muscles alongside that spine are next. And then the ribs. And then the next key. I don't remember my piano keys. If you remember them, you can label them key by key, letter by letter. Good. And now once you've made contact there, I want you to try and maintain it. You're going to inhale here. And exhale. Keep the contact. Try to press down further if you can. And inhale, maintain it. And exhale. Really try to get those ribs to melt and sink into the mat. Good, nice work. Go ahead and wiggle it out, shake it out. It's good to work hard and work into those positions, but You want to make sure that you get your blood flow going and you release it in between. Okay, so we're going to flip back to the plank work again, adding on again. Okay, so you're going to be onto your hands and knees, same start position. Hands are going to be out a little bit ahead of the shoulders. Get those suction cups down into the mat and tuck the toes under. So you're going to begin shifting your weight back towards the heels, stretching out, elongating through the spine, pulling in through the belly, and then hover the knees. You're going to shift your weight forward over the hands, back over the heels, and lower the knees down, and just stretch a little bit further. Good, find your elongation again. And then hover the knees again, and shift your weight over the hands, back over the heels, and lower the knees down. Good, elongate the spine again, really pull in through that center. You don't want to tuck under here, you want to stay nice and long through the tailbone. Exhale, hover the knees, shift the weight forward, shift the weight back, and lower the knees down. Good, elongate again, pull in through the center. We're going to do one more time. Hovering the knees, shifting forward, shifting back. Good, lower the knees, find your nice elongated spine here. Good, go ahead and roll up. You can kind of work out the fingers. Sometimes it might be a little bit better to go up once with a fist, just depending on what your hands can tolerate there. Okay, so we're going to go back and do some side plank work. I'm going to begin on my tide pool side, the side that is sunken in. And I'm going to, I'm going to be up onto my elbow here. So for this side, we're trying to not do anything super fancy. I don't want you to be sinking in super far like your little model. I want you to stay a little bit supported here, although it would be kind of okay on this side just because this is the side that we're trying to open up on. So your knees are stacked here, and I want you to lift the hips up, and then you're going to squeeze the glutes, push the hips forward towards me, and then shift the hips back and tap them back down. So you're going to lift the hips up, squeeze the glutes, press the hips forward, and then shift the hips back and lower back down. Good. So we're going to lift and press forward, shift the hips back and lower down. Good, two more times, lifting up, squeeze the glutes, shift the hips back, and lower down. One more time, lifting back up, and shifting forward, reaching the hips back, and lower down. Good. Okay, we're going to do the other side. So same thing, except we're really focused on lifting up through this side. You might even want to overdo it just a little bit, as long as you're not feeling tension in the lower back here. So I want you to begin lifting the hips up, squeeze the glutes, shift the hips forward, shift the hips back, and then lower down. So you're going to lift up and pull the hips forward, shift the hips back, and lower down. Good, two more times, lifting up, squeeze the glutes, press the hips forward, pull the hips back, and lower down. One more time, lifting and pressing forward, what we just did. Now, if your shoulder is bothering you, you can squeeze the legs together and you're going to lift the legs, rotate out from the hips, squeezing the glutes, bring the legs back into parallel and lower down. So you can lift and open, rotate, return to parallel and lower down. I'm going to progress it here. So you're going to lift the hips up in this position and then press the hips forward. And you're going to rotate that top knee open and close it back down. So you're keeping the hips pushing forward, squeezing the glutes to rotate and open and close and rotate to open. Good, you're going to do four more here. And three. Good, really pulling back strong through the center and breathing. Last time. Good, lower yourself down the whole way. And let's just do that little release through the spine. Good. Like we're a little mermaid. All right, nice, okay. And other way. Last thing here, okay? So you're going to be down onto, this is your sand dune side, the side that's pushed back. You're going to press into that bottom elbow, squeeze the glutes, push the hips forward, and then just begin rotating that top knee open and back down. And top knee opens and lower down. So you're keeping the hips pressing forward. Shoulder is stacked over that elbow. Good. We're externally rotating through both hips, actually. That stabilizing hip is pushing down and opening while the top hip is too. Good. Two more times. And last time. Good. Gently lower yourself the whole way down. Keep the knees pressing together and the feet. And just give yourself a little release through the spine. Now that was really good work. We're just going to finish with a little bit of breathing and then you'll be all set. So that went by pretty quickly, at least for me. I want to do a little bit more stuff, but I can just save it for next week. So I want you to just find your nice tall position here. You can bring your arms back by your sides. Press down into your knuckles. And lift the spine up nice and tall. So you're like, you're bracing the spine in this position. Inhaling. And then exhale, draw your tide pull back towards your back arm. And press the sand dune forward. And inhale again. Pulling that tide pull back and sand dune is reaching forward, growing nice and tall. And inhale again, last time. And exhale, try not to sink, try not to shrink. Good, very nice job, and shake it out. All right, well, thanks for joining today. If you did not understand some of the terminology, you can either reach out to me and send me a message. You can go back to some of my very first videos that I posted. I have a video on YouTube called Scoliosis Basics, and it really breaks everything down, simplifies it so that you can kind of understand and know what corrections you should be focusing on for your spine. And I just hope that you have a wonderful day and enjoyed moving with me today. I'll be back again for my mindful movement classes on Saturday, and I'll be back again for the scoliosis on Tuesday or Thursday next week. I'm not sure yet, okay? Have a wonderful rest of your day.